Yeah, that was it, dude.
And get used to a couple throws. Whenever you start throwing on the mound, first throws is just for you to feel the mound, right? How much drop there is, the hole, if it's sandy, if it's firm, the hole back there, all that. You have to feel it in the first couple of throws. Yeah. But once you go through your mechanics and you get a couple of throws, can you catch it down as much as you can? I mean, as quick as you can. You don't want to throw too many throws through your delivery and you're throwing just higher, right? Yeah.
That was nice right there.
That was better, man. That was much better. Your chest actually did what it was supposed to do better instead of just kind of like just drifting to your left, right? Right there. Just think south.
Nice.
Good call.
There you go, same thing.
It's okay. You want to practice the other pitches, right? Nice. Nice, atta boy. Very nice. You want to take a break and go change ups or?
Yeah. Focus down. Stretching out but down, right? Just backspin. That's what you have to feel it. You backspin with the ball, right? Yes. Good. One more fastball and then we'll go change ups. That was nice. Even though you kind of keep drifting, yeah. But this, it looked comfortable. It looked right.
Atta boy. Nice, Nathan. Good.
Can just get used to it, right?
Yes. Very nice.
How do you feel with your wrist when you throw the changeup? Anything special that you feel with your wrist?
Not flicking it.
Soft.
Yeah.
Super soft wrist when you throw the changeup. So it's almost like it gets flimsy when you're throwing it, right? That's when you're going to see more of this, all right? Yeah, that one you just pulled it, right? Yeah. Not bad. What do you try to feel when you release that changeup? What is it that you feel? What is it that you want to create? How do you want to shape the changeup? What kind of movement do you want to see? So how are you going to create this? Because first you got to identify what is it that you want to do with the pitch. Once you know what kind of shape you want, then you got to understand how you're going to make that break or that fade. How are you going to make it? How are you going to try to create it? You get through the inside, right? You get it through the inside, you're actually doing this when you release it?
I'm not doing that, I'm just going to shoot.
You stand right down, all right. So if you do this, how are you going to make that ball fading to the right? Can it?
Can't.
It's just going to fade down, right?
Yeah.
So go ahead and hold it. If you want to create that kind of fade, you're going to have to tilt this. So you're going to have to do this. Instead of coming so much from 12 o'clock to 6, mm-hmm. 12 to 6, you're going to have to come a little bit more across. So the spin of the changeup is going to have to be this way. So then you're going to see that thing, right? So just tilt the spin, that's all. When you throw a fastball, are you trying to get on top or where's your angle? What do you feel that your arm is actually coming through?
Straight
there, okay? What are you doing with your fingers? Are you staying here or you think that you're actually trying to climb up a little bit? So you can stay on top.
I feel like I should be on top.
For what? Well, you should be, why would you want to do this? If your arm is like this, especially your forearm. If your forearm is like that, why wouldn't you want to keep this? Because right here, your wrist is gonna work at its strongest. If you go like that, it's restricted, right? So you want to make sure that your hand, the angle, the line of your hand follows this, right?
Yeah.
So if you're here, then you want to make sure that your fingers stay on top. But if you're right here, you should be right here. And the thing that I like about this is that you're tilting the spin. So the axis of the ball is going to be right here. So when you throw it, you're going to create this, right? Instead of this. This is flat. This is going to have more movement, right? To me, movement, I like movement, right? And it's not that I want you to kind of get through the inside, because then if you get through the inside, you're going to lose velocity. But if you stay here, you still maintain your strength, and you can create that spin sideways to do this, right? As it gets to the plate, right? So the same thing should be with the changeup, right? Same thing. So go ahead and throw a couple of fastballs. And try to like tilt the spin. And I'm not saying like where it's gonna go like that, but just in the middle, in between, right? 45 degrees. What kind of movement you seeing?
I mean, it feels like I'm getting more like this.
Yeah,
instead
just be careful of that middle finger. Make sure that it's not doing this to the floor.
Yeah.
Right? Because then
I think
better,
it does this.
Right? So just make sure you stay behind.
Yeah.
You want to feel that middle finger stays more over the center, so you can do this to the floor, right? If you put it too much on the outside, you're gonna start doing this.
Yeah.
And that's when the angle wants to make the ball go this way, but since you put the finger, the outside, the middle finger on the outside, then it's doing the opposite, right? Nice, that up, boy.
That would feel better.
Yeah, that was better,
yeah,
right?
Before, I think the middle
finger. Yeah, you were getting around, and that's okay. I mean, just you can actually start working on this and then that, right, when you want to, right?
Yeah.
There you go, a couple more fastballs, and then we'll go change ups. That one you cut it. Did you feel it?
Mm-hmm.
And to me, cut, it's slower.
Yeah.
Every time that finger gets around, it just you're slowing down the ball.
It feels
right?
slower.
It just because just especially depending on how much you actually turn the ball, right? Of course, a cutter is just a little bit, slider is a little bit more, and then curveball it just gets really through. So the more you get through the ball, I mean, the more you get around the ball, the slower the pitch is,
yeah.
right? It goes from fastball. As the fastest, then the cutter, then the slider, and then the curveball as the slowest, right? Just because it's all about how much you turn the hand around the ball, right? So when you throw your fastball, you don't want any kind of turn, right? You just want to make sure you stay as much behind as you can.
Yeah.
And that's a good pitch. I mean, that's a good cutter, just protecting this, and then you throw that, right? But let's see that tilt, right? The four-seam tilt. That was better. Mm-hmm. There you go. All right, go change ups. And the change up, since the middle finger is going to be more on the inside, it should be easier. Like, the only thing that you need to make sure that you stay 45 degrees. Right? Kind of cut it. So it's just turning the wrist, right? Are you holding the change up? Alright, try. You see how much? I mean, not that it's center. I mean, but it's a little bit too much on the middle of the ball. Try to move this middle finger right here, and then just kind of move over the other finger. So this will be on the center, but this is your power finger. Now you actually just have to like move this, right? So really drag this. I mean, that middle finger. Go ahead. Roman, what's up, man? Good. It's okay. It's probably gonna feel a little different, right?
Yeah.
It's okay. Throw it again. Just kind of play catch with it, right? Nice goal. Good. Very good. That was a fastball, right? Yeah, too much. Yeah, kind of cut it. There you go. Good. There you go. Just a few curveballs, and then we'll finish with a couple of fastballs, right? Yeah, just nice and easy. Just pin them. Don't worry about anything else. Just give it a good spin. Mm-hmm. And try to take advantage of that chest being loaded back, so that you can actually have more spin to it. Yeah, dirty. Good call. Watch that landing though. Too far, yeah, too far behind. But as long as, I mean, right now, as long as you feel that it's coming out okay, I mean, that probably didn't feel good, right? Just because he was too far back, right? There you go, just one more.